In this video, we will discuss some of the parameters that are used to configure the PLC Next data logger. The concept behind the PLC Next data logger is reasonably simple. The idea is to sample data from variables in the global data space and save those in a data sink in permanent memory on an SD card, in this case, in the form of an SQLite database. The period that we sample the data from the global data space is called the sampling interval. In a typical application, the sampling interval will be of the order of milliseconds, maybe tens of milliseconds or hundreds of milliseconds. The problem with this is that it's inadvisable to write to an SD card with that kind of frequency because it affects the lifetime of the SD card. So to avoid that problem, we put an intermediate data sink between the global data space and the SD card. This is an in-memory data sink that's effectively a copy of the data sink that's on the SD card. Then, at a lower frequency, we can transfer data from the in-memory data sink to the data sink in the SD card. And the period that we do this is called the write interval. Well, it's actually important to realize that the write interval is not actually a time interval. In the PLC Next data logger, the write interval represents a count, and that is a count of the number of records that are accumulated in the in-memory data sink before that data is written to the SD card. So we would like the write interval to be as high as possible, which means we write to the SD card at the lowest frequency possible. But at the same time, if we make the write interval too large, that will use up all the available memory in the RAM. So it's a trade-off between those two factors when choosing a write interval for a particular application. And in most applications, the default write interval will be suitable. There's an additional problem with this arrangement, and that is that the samples that are taken from the global data space must be taken in a real-time deterministic manner and synchronized with the other tasks that are running on the execution and synchronization manager. It turns out that the data sync we're using is not designed to receive data in a real-time way. So to avoid the problems that this would cause, we put another buffer in between the global data space and the in-memory data sync, and we call this the ring buffer. And this is a fairly low capacity data store that just receives data from the global data space, and after a short period of time, the oldest data starts getting overwritten. So we can transfer data from the ring buffer to the in-memory data sync in a non-real-time way, and we do this at an interval called the publish interval. So the ring buffer is fairly low capacity. We can set the capacity of that ring buffer with the variable called buffer capacity. But how do we choose values for these parameters? Well, let's take an example. If we have a sampling interval of, say, 100 milliseconds, that means we're sampling variable data in the global data space 10 times a second and moving that data into the ring buffer. If we set the buffer capacity to 10, that means that after 10 samples are stored in the ring buffer, the oldest values will start getting overwritten with newer values. So really, from a time point of view, the buffer has a capacity of 1 second. That means we have to move data from the ring buffer into the in-memory data sync at least once a second. So our publish interval has to be less than or equal to 1000 milliseconds, or 1 second. The data logger represented here is called a database type data logger, where the data ends up in a data sync on the SD card in persistent memory. There's a second type of data logger called a volatile data logger, and in that case, we simply omit the final step and data just ends up in the in-memory data sync in RAM. and we can retrieve data from that in-memory data sink using an RSC service in the PLC Next runtime. But of course, when the PLC Next runtime shuts down or the PLC reboots, that data will be lost. I hope this video has been useful. If you have any questions, please ask them on the PLC Next community forum.